Good afternoon, dear educators.
My name is Varun and I'm the co-founder of Teacher.in. Thank you all for joining us today for the day 6 of certification course on NAP and digital teaching organized by Teacher.in, StudyApt and HAT India. Today, we have a very interesting topic, probably one of the most relevant topics given these times of digital teaching. The topic for the day is digital tools for effective engagement of students. Engaging students online is a very difficult task for multiple reasons. And that leaves us with several questions about how can we effectively improve online learning experience for students. And to answer all these questions, we have with us one of India's prominent teacher community leaders, the founder of HAT India, Mr. Kaushal Sen. But before we move ahead, I would like to introduce the teacher network to all the participants who joined us for the first time today. Teacher.in is a professional network for K-12 educators. At Teacher, educators can connect with fellow educators, exchange ideas and resources, attend professional development sessions like these, and find jobs and several other employment opportunities. Our co-host, StudyApt, is India's largest school search engine. StudyApt School Search Engine is a powerhouse of school search with a pan-India listing that offers a comprehensive school information of 1.6 million schools across India. We have some ground rules that we would like you to follow throughout the session. I request all the participants to please keep your mic on mute and your video off so that it saves your bandwidth and you have a better learning experience. We would also mute all the participants from our end during the session. If you have any queries and questions, you can post it in the chat box. In between the sessions, when there'd be open for, you know, questions, Mr. Kaushal would inform you and you can unmute yourself then. In addition to that, there would also be a dedicated Q&A session in the end. If you face any technical glitches during the session, we request you to stay calm and try joining the session again. We are, however, recording the session from our side and we would be sharing with you all post the session once you fill the feedback form.
Moving ahead, introducing you to the super educator of the day, Mr. Kaushal Sen.
Mr. Kaushal is currently working as TGT Mathematics at Presentation Convent School, New Delhi. He is a passionate educator who is working towards creating enriching experiences into classrooms. He is an Adopt Creative Ambassador and a Flipgrid certified educator. Along with this, he is a Teach SDGs Ambassador. He is also the founder of HAT India, a Twitter handle, and loves to expand his personal learning network for his own learning and giving back to the educator community. Thank you so much, Kaushal, for joining us today. It's an absolute honor to host you. And thank you so much for agreeing to share your wonderful knowledge with the educator community. Over to you.
Thank you so much, Varun, for introducing me and for this lovely introduction. A very warm good afternoon to everyone who has taken out time from their busy schedules and have invested their time and money to attend this session. I am deeply humbled and thankful to each one of you for joining me for today's session. And as Varun said, that today we'll be talking about digital tools for effective engagement of students. So let's get started. But before that, I would like to take up a small discussion via Mentimeter. So Varun, I would request, could you just please tell me, is my screen visible, Varun?
Yes, Kaushal.
Okay, so dear educators, I'm just pasting this link in the chat box and you have to write a strategy which you use to engage your students while teaching online. So I'm pasting the link in the chat box and I would request you all to please type in whatever your thoughts that comes into your mind. So I've pasted the link, or you can directly go onto menti.com and type in the code 4522420. So this is the code 4522420. We have taken up Mentimeter in the first session with Kavita Sangri Mang. So I hope you all will be able to join up Mentimeter. So 4522420 is the code, and I would request you all to please type in one or two words as a strategy you use, yeah, presentation, Padlet and quizzes, that's wonderful. I have started getting the answers. Okay, that's great. Let's see what others also pouring up. WordWall, Padlet, that's superb, great. Padlet is a great collaboration tool and quizzes is also a great tool. Okay, quizzes, Wakelet, that's wonderful. Storytelling, okay, that's great. We are waiting for the answers. Yes, dear teachers, you type in your answers. Peer Tech, okay, that's great, wonderful. Padlet has come up as winner because there are Padlet and quizzes. Okay, that's great. Creative Methods quiz, okay, that's great, wonderful. We'll wait for another 1 minute and after that I'll be sharing my screen. We are still have 1 minute time to go. You can pour in your thoughts. Or if you are unable to pour in your thoughts, you can please unmute yourself and tell me what kind of strategies that you use in your classroom. You can use the hand raise feature and we can take up the discussion. Yeah, anybody would like to speak anything, any other instructional strategy that they are using in the classroom during the online mode, you can use the hand raise feature. Okay, that's great. Storytelling has come up, videos has come up. Google Form, Peer Tech, Flipgrid, Wakelet. Okay, that's great. So I'm stopping sharing a screen of the Mentimeter. So dear teachers, as you already saw that we have these strategies that we are using in the classroom, whether in the form of presentation, whether in the form of videos, whether in the form of quizzes, these are the strategies that we are using. But today we'll be seeing how all these strategies can be clubbed with different instructional methods and mapped with various tools to create wonderful, engaging, enriching experiences for our students. I hope, Varun, this presentation slide is visible.
Okay.
So I warmly welcome and formally welcome each one of you to today's session, that is Digital Tools for Effective Engagement of Students. So as we all saw that you wrote things like Padlet, quizzes, presentation, videos as instructional strategies for engagement of students. But before moving ahead to any of those tools, let us understand what types of engagements that can be created in the classroom. As teachers, we should understand what are the various engagements we can create in the classroom. So I would like to quote here, "Tell me and I forget, teach me and I remember, involve me and I learn." So we should, as teachers, we should understand what are the various engagements that we can create in the classroom so that when we involve the child, we are able to help the child learn that particular concept, or whatever learning we are trying to give to the child, we are able to give that thing to the child. So let's see what are the types of engagements that we can have in the classroom. We can have social and emotional engagement. This is the first and foremost type of engagement that a teacher must have with the student. If there is no social and emotional connect between the teacher and the student, then there will be no learning happening. This is the first and foremost engagement that needs to happen, social and emotional engagement. Then once the social and emotional engagement is built, then the intellectual engagement can be taken up, or basically the classroom transaction that we take up in the classroom, the concept that we are teaching. If the social and emotional connect with the child, with the teacher is fine, then whatever concept we are teaching, that child will definitely understand. Then the next is physical engagement. Physical engagement is the kind where we try to incorporate kinesthetic form of learning style, where things are kept and the students walk, run, touch, feel, and do the activities, that is the hands-on learning or in these days, the experiential learning can be taken up in the form of physical engagement. Last but not the least, that is the cultural form of engagement. Cultural, I have used the word too because I wanted this to I wanted this word that it should be taken as a diverse niche. In the diverse nature, we have a lot of students in our classroom who belong to a diverse set of background. Somebody is from the northern part of India, somebody is from the southern part, somebody is having a religious ethnicity, somebody has a different ethnicity. So to celebrate that cultural ethnicity in the classroom, we can have cultural engagement. Now, as you all know, we are not in the physical mode of classroom. So we have to incorporate various strategies where we can create all the engagement and help our learners learn better and get them some wonderful, enriching experiences. So if I talk about the social and emotional engagement, so I would say storytelling is a great way to build up the social and emotional connect. Or I would say it is taking an interest in the personal well-being of the student. And this storytelling can be taken up with the software that is Adobe Spark. Adobe Spark is a free tool for teachers. And after the session, I would request Varun to mail me all the IDs so that I can get the free licenses for all of you mailed to your respective mail IDs. So after the session, we'll be generating your Adobe Spark licenses, which you can use free for 1 year and can create stunning posters, videos, and web pages and create beautiful experiences in your classroom. So social and emotional engagement can be taken up in the form of storytelling. Moving ahead, if I talk about the intellectual engagement, in the intellectual engagement, I would say we can take up the strategy of flipped learning. That means we can create beautiful content for our students and it can be given to the students prior to the class. They can study the content, understand the content, and the next day when the online class is happening, they can come up with their discussions and doubts and a meaningful discussion can be taken up. So for that, we'll be looking at the ThingLink app today. Then, if I would like to talk about the physical engagement, in online form, there can't be any physical engagement because we are not in physical spaces. But then also, if you want to create an atmosphere for physical engagement, then I would say gamification is a strategy which can be taken up. Or as I said, that the kinesthetic learning can be taken up, incorporated in the form of gamification. Even though gamification and kinesthetic learning, they are two separate things, but in the online mode, we can club them. For primary students, we can have various in-house activities, but for senior students, we can have quizzes like things where the gamification concept can be taken up and physical form of engagement can be built with the students. And the last that we'll be looking at is the cultural form of engagement. So for cultural form of engagement, I would recommend the strategy that is collaborative learning. And for this, we'll be exploring the tool Wakelet. This is a great, again, a free tool where students can come up together and projects can be made and collaborative learning can be explored in the classroom. So I hope you all are excited to explore all the four tools that we have seen. We'll be exploring storytelling through Adobe Spark. We'll be exploring intellectual engagement through ThingLink. We'll be exploring physical form, that is the gamification strategy through quizzes, and then the cultural, or I would say collaborative learning through Wakelet. So these are, I'll try to complete all the four tools in the stipulated time. So let's get started with the first tool, that is Adobe Spark. Just a second, dear teachers. Okay, so this is the interface of Adobe Spark. I would rather start with the sign in so that you'll be able to understand the things better. So once your emails are transferred to me for the licenses, your licenses will be generated, and after that you'll be going to spark.adobe.com. So the moment you go to spark.adobe.com, this particular page will open up, and then using the email ID registered with Adobe, you'll click on to login with Adobe ID. So I'm clicking here, login with Adobe ID. Then I am putting my email. Then the password. And here we land on to the Adobe Spark page. Now, Adobe Spark is, as I said, is a free tool for teachers and students, and we can create three beautiful things on the Adobe Spark platform. The first is posters, the second is videos, and the third is web pages are a great way to incorporate storytelling into the classroom. So let me show you how you can create web pages, and then you can incorporate your own creativity, and according to the lesson that you want to teach or according to the learning outcome that you want to achieve, you can create a web page, and in the form of story you can share it with your student. So the moment I scroll down, you can see here we can create collage, that is poster, web page, slideshow, this is video, then presentation is again web page. So web page and presentation, they both are the same thing, just different names have been given here. Then slideshow and portfolio, they again are the same thing because they are all about video. Then if you look at the green things, that is custom size, branded and graphic, these are all about the posters part. So I'll be exploring the web page with you. So I'll be clicking on to the web page part. So yes, so the moment I come to the web page part, it gives me a gray screen, and this screen is asking me a title, a subtitle, and you can see a photo option. Now, anybody would like to suggest any topic so that we can create something randomly? We can create something. Anybody would like to suggest any topic?
Trees.
Trees. Okay, ma'am. Okay, let's get started with trees. So for which grade, ma'am, should I create this?
Shrubs. Subtitle.
Okay, shrubs. Okay, so we have taken the title as trees and the subtitle as shrubs. So randomly it is coming to my mind that the story can be made in this format, that once nature was sitting and she called up all the members on the earth. She started creating everything. She started creating animals. She started creating trees. She started creating water bodies. She started creating mountains, and everybody was given the duty according to their role. Then came the trees. So trees, they then again grew up. And then in the trees part, we have three types. I think, ma'am, it is shrubs, herbs and climbers, if I'm not wrong. I'm very sorry for the content, but it will be, I think, shrubs, herbs and
creepers,
climbers, and trees okay. Are the big plants.
Okay, trees are the bigs and the shrubs are the smaller middles, and the herbs are the smaller ones. Okay, so in this way, now, as you can see, dear teachers, we have taken the title as trees and a subtitle as shrubs. So that means we'll be creating a web page on shrubs. So let us give it a beautiful picture so that it looks much more attractive. And when it reaches to a student, they feel very excited to look at this web page. So I'm going to click onto the photo part. And the moment I click on photo, you will see on the right side, these options have popped up. So the first is upload photo. So that means if on my laptop or my on my computer, if I have a photograph which I wanted to put here, I can upload that photograph. If not, then I can find a free photograph. So let me just find a photograph for tree. So, okay. I'm just choosing this randomly. So yes, so you see we have put a free photograph as the backdrop image. Okay, so now I'm going to start scrolling and I'm going to start writing the story. Now when a trees comes under EBS subject. So when a teacher is going to teach this particular subject, she will require much more content. So as to what are the various types of shrubs, what are the examples?
Types of trees. So in that shrubs, herbs, river, climbers, all at once comes.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. So when the teacher is taking up trees, so then all the types will come and then their particular explanations will come. So you see, the moment I scroll down, there are 7 options that has popped up. The first is photograph. The second is text. The third is button. The fourth is video, photo grid, glide show, and split layout. So let us explore everything in quick time. So the first is photograph. So the moment I click onto the photograph, I can choose any photograph and I can put it into my web page. Okay, I've just randomly put this photograph. So this is, I think, a berry tree. So this is a random photograph I've picked up. So in this way, you can insert photographs into your web page and then create stories. And then when you are presenting it to the students, you can narrate the stories in the form of pictures. If you don't want pictures to come in, then you can always use the text button. You can write the particular stories, the text, and then can mix and match images to that. So as you can see in the text part, you have the H1 and H2. H1 is the biggest size, H2 is the smaller size. Then if you want to put some bullets into it, you can have the bullets option. If you want the text in bold, you can make the text bold, italics, or if you wish to insert a hyperlink, you can insert a hyperlink, and then the 3 alignments are there. There is no color option, there is only black, which is the color option that's given here. So since this is a web page, so there will be no color options, only black is the color that is available. Once the text is done, then the next is the button part. Button part is a very interesting feature of Adobe Spark. In the button part, what we can do, we can insert videos, we can insert forms, we can insert any external link which we do not want to put here as an individual part. So if this particular web page is all about trees, and if I want to put up a YouTube video on trees, so what I'll do, I'll go to YouTube and I'll find something on trees and I'll just randomly I'm just taking up this video. I'm going to copy the link. I've copied the link and I'm going to simply put away. Into my web page. So you see this particular web page will have a button, which when the child will click onto this button, they will be redirected to the YouTube website. They'll watch the video and then they can come back onto the web page. So this is a very interesting feature of this web page, where you can insert external links in the form of small buttons. So till now we have seen the photo part, button part, and the text part. Now moving ahead, I'll be showing about the video part. So
Excuse me, sir, how many buttons like we can put?
You can put n number of buttons, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, sir.
N number of buttons, but the more content is put in the web page, it becomes heavy. So it, even though it is in the cloud format, but sometimes due to a large number of content, it becomes very heavy, and in some devices it takes time to load up. So like if on one device it will take 10 seconds, on other it will take 15 seconds, but it will definitely open up. So according to the content we can put up, but there's no as such limit to put photograph, video, button. There is no as such limit. You can make n number of things on this one web page.
Okay, thank you.
Ma'am. So next is, if the teacher doesn't want to put the video in the form of a button, then the teacher can directly embed the video in the web page. So I have directly embedded the video, and you can see if the child is watching the picture, then a text is written and directly a video is being embedded into the web page. So it is up to the teacher whether they want to put it as a button or whether they want to put it as a embedded video into it. The next part is PhotoGrid part. So PhotoGrid is basically collages that we create in a mobile phone. So if a teacher want to create a collage on any of the topics that she or he is teaching, then they can select the PhotoGrid part. Then in the PhotoGrid, you can insert as many photographs you want. And you suppose if I take these photographs, so I have taken, these three photographs, and you see this is a grid that has come up. So instead of one image coming at a time, all the three images are coming in the form of a photo grid. The next part is again an interesting feature of web page, that is the glide show. Glide show is basically, let me just show you. So I suppose I'm taking this picture. So I've taken this picture, and now this picture will work as a backdrop of my web page. And on this particular image, you can see a transparent rectangle box. Now on this box, you have these four options: photo, text, button, and video. So like suppose if a teacher is teaching the nomenclature or the plant or the medicinal qualities of Tulsi or Neem. So Neem tree can be put in the backdrop, and over that picture, you can have some text, that is the name. Suppose I'm randomly writing this name. So this is a Neem tree. Then if there is some qualities of the Neem tree that the teacher wants to take up, then in the form of a video, it can be placed up, or in the form of a button. Also, if the teacher wants to assess that based on the tree in the senior classes where biology is being taught in the form of organs, so then a picture of an organ can be placed up in the backdrop, and a Google form be or a Microsoft form can be embedded in the button, and then it can be taken up in the form of a assessment also. Or a story is being run. Over that story, at the end of the story, there is a small assessment. So in this way, we can teach the students the concept also, and at the same time, engagement is also done, and along with that, assessment is also done. So this was all about web page. We'll take a small 5-minute break of questions on web page, and then we'll move to the second tool. Any doubts on this particular tool, Adobe Spark, dear teachers?
So how can we share this page?
Okay, yes. Okay, ma'am. I'm coming on to that. Anything else? Anything on the inserting part, teachers?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, that photo grid for the collage, no? Is it simultaneously we can select 2-3, is it, to put it?
You can select 4 to 5 photographs, ma'am. The less the photograph, the beautifully the collage will come up.
Oh, is it?
So I recommend 4 to 5 photographs as one collage, and then you break the photographs into again 4 to 5 pieces, and then you put it up.
So if it was something like a personal, like if we want to make the pictures of students collage, how do we do it? Then do we go to our file and then get it, is it? Like,
or to insert a large number of pictures. Suppose if you want to make a collage of class students, so there are 30 students. So then you make it separately on PowerPoint or somewhere else. You convert it as image and then put it as a photo here. So that will come as a photo.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
And sir,
Sir, will this? Sorry, go ahead.
Okay. sir, please let me know about button once again.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. Yes, ma'am. There was another lady also, ma'am.
Yes, I just wanted to ask, is this can this be made into an interactive session? Like when I'm sharing this link, the child can also, give any inputs to this particular screen that I'm sharing.
Okay, that can also be done, ma'am. That is also I'm coming. Okay. So I've got some insights on what you want to know. So I am taking the button part here again, ma'am. So you click onto the plus part, then you click onto the button part. Then there is a title for a button. What title you want to give? So you give a title and then whatever link you want to paste up. It can be a form link, it can be a video link, it can be any link. It can be a photo link, Google Drive link, any link which you want to paste, you just paste the link. Then you just enter a title for that button. So I'm just putting the title as NeemTree. Then there is the alignment, center, right, left or right. So whichever alignment you want, you can just put it up. So this in this format, when it reaches the student, it will go in this format. Now, suppose the teacher has completed the web page and she want to preview it. So let's see the preview, how it will look. So this is the preview that will come up. I'll just take it to the starting part. So this is the preview. So when it reaches the student, if they are opening it on their laptop, it will come like this. But when they'll open in the mobile screen, the screen will shrink a little bit because of the size. So the child will scroll down and then in this format, the web page is coming up. There is a photograph, there is a button, then there is a video embedded, then there is a collage, and then you can see a backdrop image appears, and over that image, there are two things that has come up. So we can use our creativity accordingly, and we can use the glide show part, and then the video, the web page ends. So I'm just going back. So if one teacher asked how we can share it up, so we can click on to the share part, and then either if I want a physical copy, a PDF format, so I can always print my web page, or if I want my students to have a link for this, so I'm going to click on to publish and share link. I'm going to click on this part. Then there's a title which has come up. The teachers needs to write the title. A category is to be given. So since this is from education category, so education category, then whosoever is the author, if you want the child to see the author's name, so at the end of the web page, my name will come up. Then since I have used two free photographs, so all the photo credits are there, and then a link will be created by using the create link option. So the moment you click on create link, the link is copied, and then wherever you want to share, whether on Facebook, Twitter, Google Classroom, Teams, or on particular email, or if you want to embed it into your different kind of strategy, you can embed it there also. Also, if a teacher wants to collaborate with the student, then on this particular person plus button, you click there, and whomsoever you want to invite, ma'am, you just put the email address, and then you can invite that child to come and put the thoughts here. Okay, ma'am. So but beforehand, you must have the email ID of the child or the guardian who will be using this email ID, and then you can ask the parent to access it, and then they can come together and they can work in the real time. Okay, anything else on Adobe Spark web page, teachers? Okay, and one last thing I would like to tell, there are not many themes, but if you want to just change a little bit outlook of this web page, you go to the themes part, and then there are certain themes here, if I click on this night camp, so this particular has been changed into black part. If I come to the trek part, so I'll just show you how it will look. So see, only the fonts have been changed, nothing else. So in the themes part, nothing much gets changed, but a slight here and there, font gets changed, a little bit of color gets changed, but you don't get many options to insert colors and different fonts. But you get a lot of option to insert images, videos, and other links in the form of buttons. Yes, yes, teacher.
As you said about videos can be uploaded directly, or else, as you have mentioned about from Drive, we can say the link over here.
Yes,
so,
ma'am.
Is it for a direct or through link?
You can do it in both ways, ma'am. If you want to just like what I did here, I have directly copied the YouTube link from this particular part and I've pasted it here. So you see, this is a YouTube video which has come up. So I can directly paste the YouTube video. Or if I don't want the video to come like this, I can always have a button for that. So it's up to the teacher how they want to put it up. If they want to directly put the video, they can directly put the video. Or if they wish to hide it and let the child not get distracted from the pictures of the video, so then it can be put in the form of a button and it can be taken up as a additional resource that can be taken up. It's up to the teacher how they want
research.
To take up.
Like teacher's video I'm telling you about. Not from YouTube, not from somewhere source. Directly, if teacher want to upload a video, directly if she can do it from gallery?
No, ma'am. For that, either the teacher has to put it on YouTube, that is on free source. The teacher should put it the video on the YouTube, take the link from there and then insert her video. Directly from the gallery, it cannot be taken up. And also, teachers, Adobe Spark webpage works only on laptop and computer. It doesn't work on mobile phone. In the mobile phone, only the poster part works, not the webpage and the video. But if you have an iPhone, then all the three functions, that is the poster, webpage, and video, all the three functions will work on iPhone. But if you have an Android device, then only the poster parts work. Okay.
Fine.
Okay then let's move to the, I think let's, if you all are clear, let's move to the second tool of today, that is the curiosity building or the intellectual engagement tool that we'll take up today. So let's get started with the second tool, that is Thinglink. So I'll just log out and I'll just log in again. So the second tool that we are looking today is the Thinglink part, that is developing curiosity in our students. Because if you look at the current scenario, the knowledge is dispensed at every place, whether it is Vedantu, whether it is Byju's, students are going to various websites and taking up the knowledge there itself. But then also the need for teacher and the need for teacher to develop that curiosity will always remain. So I have chosen the tool Thinglink. So you have to type in thinglink.com/edu, which is all about for teachers and school. So you click, go to Google Chrome or any other browser, you click on to thinglink.com/edu, then you go on to the login part. Then you can see, you can log in via third party apps also, like Microsoft, Google, Facebook, Twitter. So I'm I'm logged in using my Microsoft account. My Gmail account is also a Microsoft account. I've converted my Gmail into Microsoft account. I'm so sorry. Okay, so here I have just clicked on to Microsoft and I have entered into my Thinglink account. Now this is a free account. If you want much more features, you can always upgrade it, but I would recommend that the free account works very well. So now in this Thinglink part, we can create images which will have embedded videos, audio files, or text file, and it will create a picture into a beautiful and an interactive picture. So let me just take up any picture. Okay, let me just take up
से लिखने लगी है अब जिंदगी ये दास्तां.
Yeah, that's a nice song, but let's enjoy that song later. Okay, so as you saw that I just downloaded a fruits photograph, and let me just create a image. Okay, so as you see, this is the picture that will be going to my students, but now let us put things which will make this picture interactive. So since this picture is all about fruits, so what I did, I'll just go again. I'm going to go on to create. I'm going to upload an image. So wherever you have your image, you take that image, and then the image comes in front of you. Then if you come to the left part, you can see add tags. And this is where the main beauty of this particular tool comes in. So using tags, if I click on to the tags part, you will see we can insert text and media. We can insert text labels. We can add content from website, and we can create a tool. So if a social science teacher or if a science teacher wants to create a tour of any muscle or of any organ, or if a social science teacher wants to create a tool for any historical monument, then all the pictures can be clubbed together and a beautiful tool can be created. But we are only looking at the interactive picture part today, so I'm just talking about the picture part. So as you can see, my tag has come up. This plus button is the tag part. So let me just start putting text into my tag part. So this part will come up, a white page will come up, and on the left side you can see there are three things: title, description, and button. So let me just put the title, fruits. If a teacher has a description, they can put a description. Also, if you want to put up a video, you can put up a video. Okay, so so I'm randomly taking up this video. I'm copying the link, and then I am putting my URL. Now, if a teacher wants to add up her or his own voice, then they can upload the audio file and they can make that picture interactive. So what we did, we first chose the insert text option. Then when you choose the insert text option, it will ask what kind of text you want to put, what description. So let me just type the description. Names of different fruits. So this is the description I've taken up. Then the button URL. If you want a button text, you can put up a button text. Okay, I can put up a button text. Fruits name. And then if you want another image to be embedded into this image, you can always insert an image, and then you can change up. Also, if you wish to change the icon, so then you click on to the icon part, and whatever icon you feel like is going with that particular image or that particular content, you can choose that. So I'm going to take the plus button. Then if you click on to the plus button, there are 4 or 5 color options. You can insert any of the color options and you can take up. So you see, this is a beautiful red button has come up, and you see the transition is always going on. That means the button is throwing light. So when this particular image will go to my child, they will click onto the plus button, and the moment they click onto the plus button, let me just click onto the done part. Let me show you the preview part. So this is the button, this is the image that will go to my student, and the moment my child will click onto this plus button part, they will see the title, and then if they click onto the button part, they will be again redirected to the YouTube website where they can watch the video. If the teacher wants to put up their own audio files, then they can always put their audio files. If you wish to drag the button anywhere, so you take the cursor and drag the cursor any which way. So since this is a picture with a lot of fruits, so we can add buttons on all the fruits, and it can be shared with our students. So on banana, there can be one button. So if I put this button on the banana, then things for banana can be put up. Then on papaya, another tag can be taken up. On apple, another tag can be taken up. So this way, our images become much more interactive and they communicate well with our student. So this image can be, so once the image is done, then you go to the share part, then you click onto the share link part, you copy this link, and then you can share it across with your student, which can also be done in the form of flipped learning. The students can recall the concept, they can understand the concept, and the next day a discussion can be taken up. If you want to download this image in the physical space, then you need to have an upgraded account. Or if you wish to publish it any which way, then you can publish it on these particular sites. So yes, teachers, anything about this Thinglink part? And do tell me, is this interesting or not? It, because I love this very much, because it creates an image and it makes the image very interactive. And when students see these kind of interactive images, they get very excited, and then the engagement, that is which we are talking about, it increases much more into the classroom.
Sir, I want to ask something. Like for yes. This also, we upload our video on YouTube.
If you want to insert your own video, ma'am, that needs to have an open source link. Or what you can do, you put it into Google Drive and you click onto the sharing link, make it open, and then you can insert the video part. So what I did here, you see, ma'am, if I click onto this button part, and if I want to edit this part, so you can always paste your Google Drive link here. You paste the Google Drive link, because all our videos get saved in the Google Drive, or the if you are using Android, iPhone, then it goes to the cloud, iCloud. You take the link from there, you paste the URL, and then the students can see your own video. There's no need to upload it on YouTube. That way also it can
okay, be sir. One more thing.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, sir. One more thing. If I upload my audio, then what about the original audio of the video? It will be attached with the video, or what will happen?
So, ma'am, as I told, that we can insert as many tags. So if I put this tag, suppose I want to add I want to again add a media tag. So let's take a pineapple, and then you want to insert an audio about pineapple. So then you just use the microphone, or if you have already or recorded audio, you just insert it and then you just paste it. So you see, let me just change the color. Okay, ma'am. So this is, so the moment the child clicks on red button, the child will see another video. The moment the child clicks on this yellow button, another video will be played. The videos will not be overlapped, ma'am.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you.
So this is a great way, because it makes the pictures very much interactive. And inside one picture, we can insert a lot of content. Again, there is no limit to the content that we put into one picture. So the moment child clicks on any of the tag, that particular content will be played, and the other content will not be played until and unless the icon is tapped around. Yes, teachers, anything?
Oh, yes. Question out of the source, sir. Like Google Drive, do we have any particular MB that need to fill because like 50 to 60 videos if we upload, so there is some particular timing or limit for drive. Is it the same, the limited period is there for dumping the drive or like videos, or else it's like we have much more space that we can fill up, how much videos we can?
Ma'am, Google Drive, the free account, there is a limited space. There's a limited space, and once the space is filled, it asks you to delete the things. So it's better to upload it on YouTube, because these are all instructional videos which we teachers make. So if we put it on YouTube, which is an open source platform, so taking the videos from YouTube, which will be much more easier, and our phone storage will also be clean. So it's better to put the videos on YouTube and help the other students also, and from open links can be taken up and inserted in the picture.
Okay, fine sir.
Yeah, because ma'am, Google Drive has a limited space. After that space is filled up, it asks you to remove the content from there.
Okay.
I can see Rupa ma'am's hand is up. Yes, Rupa ma'am, you want to ask something?
Hello, sir.
Yes,
like what I would like to know is like something in maths also, in you know, if you could show, it would be nice.
Okay.
For the primary students.
Okay, so Rupa ma'am, what we can do in this link only, we can take up a shapes picture which has triangle, square, rectangle and circle. All the four shapes can be made up, and in the four shapes we can put the tags, and then it can be made up in the form of an interactive part. Also ma'am, I would like to show that I created a divisibility movie on Adobe Spark itself, and students liked it very much. It was a simple video which has certain numbers, and the rules were coming as a scroll. So that can also be taken up. So that way we can take up things like that, and we'll be exploring it, the various activities in the Q&A, ma'am. Okay, Rupa ma'am?
Yes, sir, because maths is one thing I think we should make it very interesting, because everybody finds maths as a difficult subject. Most of the students, to make it more attractive, I think, you know, something in animated form, and, you know, if we could display like that, it would be really great help. Thank you, sir. True. Thank you very much. Wonderful, actually, to watch.
Okay, ma'am. So as I said to Rupa ma'am, that instead of a fruits picture, we can have a shapes picture, or if we are teaching geometry and we have to take up a specific topic, that is quadrilateral. So a quadrilateral can be taken up, and tags can be inserted in the form of square, rectangle. And when the picture reaches to the student, they do not have to tap up multiple links, like what we are facing in our online teaching initially, that we had to send multiple links to our student. But if we send one picture which has all the necessary links tapped or embedded into that picture, then it is also easy for the students also, and also for the parents, because inside one picture every information is there. So you can insert your own audio file, you can insert your own videos, and you can insert your own images also. So this way ThingLink can be used up in the form of flipped learning, and it is the second tool that we have covered up. If there is any other questions on ThingLink, otherwise we'll move to the third tool for today. Any other questions on ThingLink, teachers?
Sir, can you please show me the login procedure again, please?
Okay, ma'am. So login is very easy, ma'am. You go to thinglink.com/edu. Slash edu is the particular website. thinglink.com/edu. You go to this website. Then you go to login. Then whichever way you want to log in, by the Facebook, Twitter, Google or Microsoft, whichever way you want to log in, you log in. Or if you wish to use a separate email and a password, you put those things, you enter into it, and the free account, and you can make videos, images and VR tools. But for VR, I would say the student must have those VR glasses. If the VR glasses are not there, then it is waste. So it's better to make interactive images and promote flipped learning in the classroom. Okay, dear teachers, it has been a lot of talking from my side. Now let us play a small quiz and let us engage with each other in the form of a quiz. So this is a small random quiz which has been created on NEP. I would request you all to join up this quiz. I am pasting the link in the chat box. You please go to the link, then enter your name, and then we'll start the quiz. So I'm pasting the link. Varun, is the link pasted?
No, not, sir. Not yet.
Okay. Just a second, teachers. I think my Teams is hanged. Okay, rather I would suggest you please open a separate browser and then type in joinmyquiz.com and then enter the code 141183. I would request everyone, yeah, I can see Supriya Roy ma'am has entered. That's great. You please go to joinmyquiz.com. You type in this in a separate browser, enter the code 141183. And then as soon as the members enter, we'll start the game. That's great. I can see 17 members have joined in. That's great. We'll wait for another 2 to 3 minutes for all the other teachers to join up.
Sir, can you please repeat how to join the my quiz app?
Okay, ma'am, you open a separate browser and then type joinmyquiz.com. The moment you type this, it will ask you a code. So ma'am, the code is 141183. After you put the code, it will ask you your name. So once you enter your name, you are here in the room. Okay, so we have around 28 members inside the room. I'll wait for another 1 minute. At 5, I'll start the quiz so that we all can experience the quizzes part. That is the gamification part, or I would say the physical form of engagement, which in the online form can be clubbed as the physical form. Okay, so dear teachers, now the questions will start appearing on your screen, and on my screen, a leaderboard will appear. So in another some seconds, I'll be just starting the quiz. It's 4:59. At 5, I'll start the quiz. Okay, it's 5. So on my count of 3, 2, 1, the quiz starts. So at 5:03 p.m. I'll just end the game. You have still have 2 minutes time, dear teachers. Each question is of 45 seconds, so you have time.
Hello, sir. I have done the quiz.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. Okay. So, dear teachers, it's 5:03 and I am ending the quiz. That's wonderful that the first position is backed by Padam Priya, ma'am, and the second position is backed by Balwinder Singh, sir, and the third position is backed by Munira. So I hope you all have liked this activity. So dear teachers, this is the third tool that we are covering today, that is Quiz Is. So it is again a very good tool to effectively engage our students in the online mode of learning. And also there is...
Really, sir. Great, sir.
Thank you, sir. So this in the quizzes part, which I feel is a great, feature, that there is no limit of the students entering into it. I have myself have tried it with around 180 students. So it is, I would recommend that it can be taken up with 150 to 180 students in one single time, in one single take. So 150 to 180 students can come together into a room and then the teacher can effectively play the quiz. So you log in, you log in with any of the credentials, either Gmail or any which way. Then you go on to the explore part. In the explore part, you can explore any of the quiz. No need to make up any quiz. So somebody will say how to prepare the quiz. It will take a lot of time. No need to prepare the quiz from your side. You just type in the title, what title you want. Suppose I want it on triangles. So now you see 135,115 results have been found out. So now you can filter it according to your grades. So whether you want it for elementary, middle school, suppose I want it for middle school. Then based on the filters applied, I can see a lot of quizzes are there. So whatever quiz you feel like is appropriate for your class or whatever quiz has the maximum questions which can be taken up by your class, you choose that quiz. So suppose randomly I am choosing this quiz, that is triangles, and it has 10 questions. So I choose this quiz. Okay, the quiz is chosen. Now, if I see that all the questions are correct, only one or two changes are required. So then you click on to the edit part and whichever question you want to edit up. So the duplicate is created. So now whichever one or two question you want to edit, you edit that question part. You can insert mathematical symbols also. Again, a great tool for the mathematics teachers. They can insert symbols. So if I click on to the symbols part, you can see we have the basic symbols, Greek symbols and the advanced symbol. So a tool for maths and science teachers in the senior classes, they can insert the symbols and they can create the quizzes accordingly. If you want to add up equations in the question, that can also be done in the question also, and the equations can be done in the solutions also. So now, as you saw, that this quiz has 10 questions, and out of those, I have just changed one question. So no need to create your own quiz. You just look at the library, you take up a quiz from there, you make certain changes here and there, and your quiz is ready. Once the quiz is ready, you can change the time options, and then you click on done part. Now, once you click on to the done part, how to share it with the students and in the real time, like we did here in the real time, you go onto the start a live quiz. If you want to do it in real time, you click on start a live quiz. Or if you wish to assign it as homework in the asynchronous mode of learning, then you can assign as homework also. So like I played live, and most of you would like to ask your students to come live. So I'll click on to the live part, then I'll click on to the classic part, because the instructor paste is the paid version. So I'm going to click on to the classic part. And in the classic part, I will continue. Since classic is already chosen, I'll click on to the continue part. Then once I continue, again the same instruction I'll give to my student, which I gave to you. Go to joinmyquiz.com, enter the code, enter the name, and then everybody starts joining in here. So all the teacher taking the quiz can see who has joined, who has not joined. And if a child has joined from two devices, so you can always remove that player. So a fair chance is given to everyone. And after the quiz is completed, you can see a leaderboard is created. And using that data, the teacher can understand where exactly the child is lacking in the concept. So that way, quizzes can be taken up in the classroom.